4:18 a.m., left boob. The baby saw a spirit clowning on the ceiling. The thing or things not there, certainly amusing. The baby's face is kind of flat. That's beatific. I scare easily. A manner of the poem can be found in the way it is possible to discover that one need no longer be cold, that one's coat is sufficiently warm and dry, that this happened to me in Jersey City in 2004 in a blizzard, that I forgot again that my mother is a doctor because she is my mother. She assures me I need only be good enough, that Winnicott is the one to read on this. I wasn't thinking and should have said thank you, that only the pain of his latch is real. His latch is the measure of all pain, itself a thing invented nightly as in a dream of taxes. Of the long poem, I had said there could be a secret text, a sacred accompanying text, unreadable but for its having been written and erased. But how to establish secrecy? Not undiscovered, nor buried, then unearthed. Its paradigm is the burning bush, psychosis materiel, madness of cause. There must, I'm saying, be a listener, also mad, ready with testimony to extinguish doubt. There must be witness and whispering and uncrated objects that have not been touched except by these two. The primary position taken by me as against the secondary position, the backward, the prone, that is the point. The point being to run down the arbiters of licensing the demand for pictures. Show me an image of your perfect listener. Deep sound, trash musicality, folklore of the herd, remnant of the flightlessly flapped wing, I forbid. I forbid pathos and contrast. Forbid that too. Me in the primary position. The primary position's rough justice being to run down the arbiters of listening. Put myself to the side of listening. Put myself over listening, take a vacation from listening and listening's homonym, utterance, and listening's key practice, damnation. On whose part comes such failure of imagination? Upon whom does it come? Upon nothing of threat. Straddle this longing. It is circular. It's self-regard, which is also flat, abiding, anti-calculation.